Hey guys, welcome back to XCOM, and we're fucking doing a landing, a UFO landing site. Yeah, let's go. Let's send everyone in. Yeah, fucking Sky Ranger launch, go. If you're just tuning into this episode and you don't know what fucking my people have equipped, then maybe you should go watch the last episode. I know I didn't even show it, but you know, what's the point?
Dropship has arrived.
You know, it just occurred to me someone may have gone to sickbay. No, no one took damage. Should be this team.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States.
Yeah, no one died. It's okay. So, Sky Rangers landed, and we're kind of pissed because we didn't even get to take it. We just got fucking home, and it's just like, well, it's time to turn the car around for the Sky Ranger.
Big Sky, we're in position and awaiting further orders.
Roger that, Big Sky. Strike one, you are green to deploy. Approach with extreme caution. Current enemy status at the site is unknown.
Well, this looks like it's going to be a slightly bigger mission. But this is what we train for, gentlemen. Alright, well, let's get everyone into positions. I don't know what to do with my snipers. It just occurred to me that they shouldn't have been the first move here. Oh. Whatever. I have to watch. They'll be okay. It's like they're in light cover right now. We hear something. Oh Jesus, it's chrysalids through the wall. Good thing I didn't move them. Haha, fuck. Love these guys. Alright. Okay, now, you're probably wondering what the hell am I gonna be doing here? And that's, I know you think this is kind of fucking nutso, like I'm just moving kind of everybody back. The reason I'm doing this though is we just saw chrysalids. Grouping doesn't matter. What matters is that they may come around a corner and they may be getting melee range like pretty much immediately. I know they'll get bored because they have no corpses or shit to make their like fucking chrysalid children or whatever the fuck they do. Okay. Oh, let's go move this guy up here. Eventually they'll come out. Don't make me come after you, fucking chrysalids. Alright, well, let's go see what's actually in there, then. Okay, that's half cover. This is full cover. Can you tell the difference? Holy shit! Holy shit again. Marines! We are leaving! No! Bad game. We're just gonna wait for them to come to us. If they want a taste of the mic lab, they will have to come to the mic lab. Alright. We saw someone there. SGT Dan is in a very terrible spot to help cover. So he will just come right here. And hopefully, we're gonna get some opportunities to shoot some dudes soon. What the hell are they shooting at? What the hell is going on? I'm scared and aroused at the same time. Alright, this is not good. Okay, well, we have to kind of poke our heads out and see what's up here. Alright, looks like we're kind of going to head over here then. This goes completely against my better judgment. But it looks like no no UFOs or shit, whatever, wants to come out today. And people are getting lonely. Mr. Shiv, you will do us the honors and poke your head out. Now, this is quite possibly the worst situation we're in. There's about fucking 10 groups of activated enemies. We don't know where any of them are. We don't even know where the fucking sectopods are. Okay, someone's gonna die this mission. I've already called it. Oh, here we go. It's a drone. Fucking Mr. Shiv, you kill stealing ore. Oh god, one just came out of like fucking oh man, never mind. Mr. Shiv is a kill stealing ore. Just gonna tell you that right now. Still have some chrysalids out on the map somewhere. What the fuck just did they blow up then? Okay. We have a rocket shot we can take, however, he won't be behind cover when he takes it. He, however, will, and he can actually make it. Why he was shooting there, I'm not actually- Oh, he knew where we were. But we'll just, we'll go rocket his ass. Okay, that will help. Alright, so we kind of need to get behind cover here. I'd rather not go behind the giant explosive thing here. Because in my adventures, I've kind of learned that's a really bad idea. We can suppress him, and we can shoot at him with this. The problem here is my snipers can't actually get up in a position to actually fire at him. I was hoping Dan would be able to dash over there. Okay, well. Now, you're about to learn that sectopods are actually nothing to be trifled with. They're really horrifying, because they're just... They do a lot of damage. Oh shit, I meant to actually make him mess up his aim. Yeah, he, I think, has an overwatch, though, at the ready. Oh no, he gets a second shot, which he uses to shoot him. Oh, god damn it. Okay, you need to do something about your health. Yeah, this is why sectopods are something not to be trifled with. Ah, man. Okay, you get behind this wall here. You have a fun time right here. He's got 10 HP to heal. Look at that. That's sweet. That was not even a laughing matter. And if I was behind that, I'd be in an even worse spot. All right. Unfortunately, that removes my shot that I just opened up. Now, I have a couple of options. I can just kind of dash them to cover like this. And I'm actually inclined to kind of do that. Because they're not in a position, and I doubt... Like, I don't think the Archangel armor would really help me in these cases. But it does really help to have this. Because we can just become invisible. And dash directly into the place we want to go. Now, question is, do we want to kind of just go right up here? I'd actually prefer to come down here. Okay. So, what he's going to do is he's going to go over here and he's going to try and fuck up his aim. So, you're not shooting anyone else. Mr. Shiv probably shouldn't stay in a place where he and his friend can get shot. So, we're gonna move him to down here, just to make sure our back is covered. So he is shooting at our heavy here. It's terrible. We never want to get into that kind of position. Okay, so we have been revealed. Our snipers have been, that is. Whoops. No. Don't overwatch with a plasma pistol. It's a terrible idea. What I want you to do is I want you to finish him off. And there you go. That's how we do it. This is how I get freaked the fuck out because I don't know where the rest of them are. There's like mutants and some other shit around here somewhere. You simply don't know. Now we're just gonna all huddle beside this this power generator looking thing. That's a really good idea. I'm just full of good ideas. Does he have his plasma? Yeah, he has his plasma pistol. Oh, here we go. Oh god, don't fucking destroy that thing. Don't make me regret everything I've ever done. Oh Jesus. No, I'm sorry. I did not say anything negative about your mother. The hell? He's all sparkly glowy. It's better love story than Twilight, XCOM is. Alright, well we got him, so we're okay. Now you know we can actually do the shoot and scoot thing, which is actually kind of fun. Oh god. Aliens! You apparently ducked behind there. Can I actually still? No, I can't shoot him still. Okay. Shoot and scoot time. He doesn't have a place he can go really, so he's actually gonna go straight back here because I don't really actually know what to do with him. If I keep him there, he'll get blown up, and the chances are someone's gonna get grenaded this next turn. So. Oh, there goes the wall again. Guys, we're supposed to bring this UFO back in one piece. Kinda wanna salvage it. Yeah, that's what I thought, he's gonna grenade. But there's only two of them together, so it's okay. Oh, you're really proud of yourself, aren't you? Well, Volkov doesn't really like your smug attitude, but actually Dan doesn't like your. Well, actually, it's a 65. That's a 65%. That's good enough for me. No, it's better than them being beside the other thing. All right, well, you can just heal yourself. No, heal yourself. God damn it. Mr. Shift probably should have done. Now he's back at full health. There you go, see? I love it when the planet comes together. Oh, hey, chrysalid. Oh, we can take a shot at you. So it's just gonna be all over the map, apparently. I think the last chrysalid is probably in the cockpit. He's probably driving. Chrysalids have been known to do that on occasion. We just can't stop them from driving. And we've done this map too. This is happens to be just coming from another angle. Alright, well, let's see what we got. We can go completely up the side here, that sounds kind of safe. Let's do that. And luckily my snipers can go really far up. Check this shit out. We can go super far. So let's go see what's inside that cockpit, because I'm not really that worried. I mean, I know we're hearing like little bumps in the night and other fucking crap like that, but I mean, seriously, it's not that spooky. Oh shit! Like that, everyone. Hey! What's up? Yeah, no. Hey, don't move, Zhang. Thanks. Alright, let's see. We got another good move here. What the hell is that even? Oh, it's a chrysalid. Oh, we almost have him. Oh, we can get another shot off with him. Fucking chrysalids. When will you learn? Okay, so since most of our guys took shots this turn, we're gonna just overwatch everybody. Well, that was a fun adventure, wouldn't you guys agree? And the last place is pretty much the cockpit. You wanna call it the cockpit? Because insert sexual joke here, that's why. Yeah, okay. Well, we're just gonna pretty much just run and dash up there. Oh, by the way, I can't capture chrysalids either, in case you're wondering. You can only kind of just look at them. Oh god, sectoids. Oh shit. No, don't go in there. Are you fucking assholes? When I come in there, I'm gonna stun gun you fuckers, okay? It's like, oh god, it's XCOM. Flee. Alright, so we're gonna do the obvious smart thing and make everybody kinda crowd, like, kinda bunch up. Oh wait, what? Oh, what the fuck is- what? Yeah, sure. I mean, I don't even ask these days. I guess he's from earlier and he's kind of just like, hey, I'm just gonna go ambush XCOM and then immediately gets fucking wrecked. Alright, let's see if the sectoids want to come out and play with us today. Oh, you did not just mind melt. I wonder if I stun one of them when they're mind-melded, will I stun both of them? You know, this is the kind of questions you ask when you play XCOM. And it's something that's worth trying, at least from my perspective. Alright, and last guy will be right here. Actually, the last guy should have been on Sniper Overwatch. Oh fuck, do we seriously hear someone behind us now? God damn it. It's gonna be a fucking witch hunt again. Alright. Oh, here we go. No, don't kill him. Fuck! I want to see if I can kill Mind Melder. Alright, well, breach and clear. Show me your hands. Oh shit, there's more than one. Okay, well, obviously that's not the bigger threat anymore. So, we could just rocket their asses. I mean, look at this. Destroy all the cover, sure, let's go. You know, no one ever said Mike did things like the simple way. Yeah. All right. And, how the hell do I get in there? Oh, here we go. I'm, like, wondering what the fuck it's doing. Alright, on the ground now. The hell else do we see? He looked like he could see two. Oh, no, no, he just sees one. It's okay. I can not see anybody. Totally capable of seeing him. Alright. Wow, you killed him in one hit? Wow, you're a fucking monster. Well then. Another fun episode of XCOM brought to you by stun guns and ridiculous criticals and shit like that. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, they're fucking Muton elites. That's not good. We're in no position to fucking take these guys out. This guy is, though. So, we bring ourselves into one of these positions where I'm being surrounded and flanked by Muton elites. So, what do you do? And the answer to that is, you cloak. Because they don't fucking know where I am. And now, this brings you into lots of opportunities for flanks and shit like that. And here they are. And speaking Overwatch. So, they have no idea where the fuck my guys went. They're like, oh god. XCOM is a strange and mystical, powerful race. And, you know, they do great scouting too, but it's just like, you know, it's... What would I do in the case of... Holy shit. Nice fucking shot. What would I do in the case of if he didn't have cloak? Well, you know, my options would be a little bit more limited. That's a really piss-poor chance to hit. Well, we have a couple of options here. Let's just be a total asshole. Let's do that. Let's do, cloak engaged. So if he decides not to move anywhere, we're gonna just dash up here, and we're gonna shoot him on the next turn. You know, hopefully I'm convincing someone out there that this is a good idea. Because everyone seems pretty universally opposed to having snipers with ghost armor. Here we go. Dan gets another opening. You sexy fucking beast. I love you.
Mission accomplished.
Marry me, Dan, please. Be my wafu. Or waifu or whatever, I don't know what it is. That was a fun and adventurous mission. I love that. Let's go home, guys. And hopefully there's not gonna be another stupid UFO on the way back in the Sky Ranger. Well, Triple Strike's a bit wounded for a couple days. He's just gonna take some R&R. Got some... a lot of resources, some weapon fragments and shit, too. But, you know, what the hell else do you want me to do? Well, let's just, keep the world go spinning round and round. See if anyone's done their psi testing.
We may be onto something, Commander. Our latest candidate is... different. We're picking up levels of psionic energy unlike any we've detected in the previous tests. Ever since mankind first looked up at the stars, we have wondered what lies beyond. So very few have dared to look inward. The depths of the human mind hold more secrets than we can possibly imagine. How ironic that the means to defeat our enemy comes not through weapons or machines of war, but from within. And if we have succeeded, we will have gained a glimpse of what we are to become. We will have created something extraordinary.
Oh, Mr. Colon is gifted. Who would have thought? Alright. Let's have a look at, which one is he? He's, the sniper, so he is the replacement for Sergeant Dan. Sorry, Sergeant Dan. Fortunately, only one ability. But also gets Mind Fray. That's kind of nice, too. We'll start dicking around with setups in a little bit. But, there you go. It's not too shabby. Let's see, Psylabs. Okay, so we need another one too. Not XXX snipes. I was hoping actually to get a heavy. No, actually no, not him. Sorry, not Zhang. Need Zhang. We'll have Viper and a support as well, because that was going to replace Triple Strike. No offense to anyone who gets supported to change, because it's just I just want at least like a couple of Psy people. I'm looking for at least three with high will. I don't know how high the will go, but yeah. So that's not too shabby.
Do we not have an ethical obligation to prepare these soldiers for the changes, permanent changes, that they will experience?
So I have nothing else really
Mark
to do
it in
here.
The history books. This is the end of an era for mankind. Even after we've defeated the remaining aliens, what then? Have we sacrificed our own humanity for a taste of their technology? And if we manage to exploit this power further, do we risk being consumed by it, presumably just as they were?
These advancements could completely change the course of scientific progress. A new, untouched field of study just waiting for able minds.
Cool. Okay, and she has nothing else to say. Anyone else? Anyone
have
anything?
Satellite uplink facilities at maximum capacity.
Oh, we got the
additional
gray market.
Uplink required.
I mean, I destroyed some shit, so might as well. And surgery is useless, and so is alien stasis tanks. That's it. Alright. Well, let's go scan for some activity, shall we? Alloy research is complete. That's the alloy cannon. It's the super shotgun, basically. The rest of this is just, it's just not useful, because it's just like, well, we could if we're bored. You know, just, like, if we feel like 100% of the game, that's just fucking skeleton suits.
Incoming transmission.
Excellent work, Commander. This council is pleased to see our continued support of this project has been worthwhile. We hope that your current successes only mark the beginning of an enduring effort to eliminate the extraterrestrial threat.
We got 2,000 bucks for this shit. Nice.
We will be in touch, Commander.
All right. And workshops still have like 2 days.
Contact detected.
And there's a UFO contact. Send, I know we only have a couple of ships. I don't even know if I should bother getting else. I think I should get like at least the thing where I can
engaging
extend
bogey.
The time for it, but you know. Because they could go fast, like really fast. This one's not even gonna be a problem though. It's not even damaging me. I'll get wrecked. Well, we'll send the Skyrunner for next time, but, sorry, SGD Dan. You've served me well, but not well enough, apparently. So, let me just strip you of your rank and your goodies. Sorry. So who do we have? We have... My Psy soldier is going to be Mr. Colon, who looks like that, apparently. I haven't really styled them at all. Yeah, we'll do Ghost Armor. I'll stall him for next time. We're actually going to take the alien grenade because we want to get a really easy kill with him. I don't even know if actually I should take Ghost Armor. Should actually maybe consider giving him Titan Armor because of the fact he's so new to being a sniper. He can't squad sight. I don't know. We'll see. He's got really high. He's got really high will. Hopefully by the end, though. So we have him. And so a question I was getting actually was is the guy what's his name? Negro, is he black? This is totally random, by the way. Yes, he is. Well, that does it for this. So I hope you guys are enjoying, and remember, we will be watching.